Well, we've got other people saying it's thousands of years ago. It was mentioned that the moon was
the constellation in the sky.
A lamp, reflecting light.
A sun.
But I wasn't alive those many years ago, personally. See,
the Arabic word used for moonlight in the Quran.
So you can say like, he's saying like atheists, like they're like they've read the scientific book and that is their Bible. That's not me. I'm not religious. I'm not part of a sect. I'm me, my individuality, and I'm living right now. So every time he says, then the atheists believed this in so many hundreds of years ago, well, I didn't, because I wasn't around those many years ago. So I'm not I'm not part of a sect.
Nur or Nur, meaning reflected light or borrowed light. It is spherical. When did we come to know? So he will tell us.
So you've got the spherical earth bit, right? And he says, oh, hang on, this is good.
It was 1597 when Sir Francis Drake...
1597, whatever. Francis Drake. Well, I wasn't around in 1597 when Sir Francis Drake. I wouldn't, myself, personally, I wouldn't believe it then, because I wasn't around. And as for atheists being around those days, well, I think very few were, because it's all very, very religious and Christian in those days for England. So, and anyway, it's supposed to be, was it some Greek, or Aristotle, and then it's, after that, it's all still a bit Greek-y, and the whole flat earth thing was a bit of a myth anyway, that come up in some fictitious Columbus book that someone wrote. It's all politics.
The atheist may say, your prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, may be your intelligent man. Don't argue with him. Continue.
That's rude, isn't it? Don't argue with him. Continue. Now, if I use that language here, don't argue with him. Continue.
On which we live.
I'll be accused of stuff, I'm sure of it.
It is spiritual. When did we come to know?
And here he says, and after Sir Francis Drake, then we took it as spherical.
And we know
completely wrong.
Who could have mentioned 1400 years ago that not received about his own access? So they said, is that mentioned in the Quran? I said, no, that is what I learned in school. And I passed my school in 1992.
Well, we got these great astronomers about axes and stuff and barrier centers. I never learned some stuff. I think Newton does some good work. But I'm not sure how much math you'll get in a religious book.
Allah has created the night that mentioned this in the Quran 1400 years ago.
So everything's 1400 years ago. So to wipe all this stuff out, because he's saying it's like a Russian's first thing, it's like copyright sort of thing, and he's going by everything that he can beat by 1400 years, 100 years ago, that he's got you beat. If he can get before you, that is his big argument, Zaki and Nake. If he beats you by in that 1400 time span, he's got you beat. Oh no, you've beat me to it. You get a date before that, and he's screwed. That's a weird way of looking at religion and science, though. I was the first logic. You're so great, you eat my eight. So he rattles his stuff out of the book.
Which only speak about which science has discovered this. We can keep on.
He says about recent discoveries of science, but you just realise this. But science is like a methodology, really. Science isn't great in itself. You get theories and ideas, but then they get knocked down by better ideas and ones that are more solid. And it's sort of a fluid thing. But what's more permanent is the methodology, you know, testing ideas. And that's what religion is. Religion doesn't test ideas. Although it does evolve in its own way, because it's like you go from early Christianity to all those fractures of splitters, and it's sort of an evolution of itself.
It is the mountains which prevent the earth from shaking, which is mentioned in the Quran 1400 years ago.
Mountains prevent earthquakes from shaking. It's stupid stuff. It's all about biology, right?
That we have created,
it's all recent stuff.
From water. Every living thing.
Every living thing born from water. Well, there's a water cycle.
Quran mentioned this.
But if you think on the bigger picture,
the Quran speaks about zoology,
of where
about the lifestyle of the spider,
life actually comes from right at the start.
About the ant.
You've got to go right back to the first atomic.
About the bee in Surah An-Nahl.
the smallest atomic, you know, particles from the Big Bang. Because if you go back far enough, that's where you end up. If you say you come from water, that's you're saying that he's like, oh, water is the first sort of like has a brain to make then make life. Water got no brain. Water is a couple of atoms. So why does life start at water? What's so special about water? Water is just water. After everything, you can go back to the smallest particle and say that is the beginning of life.
The only reply the atheist can give you is the creator.